models that enable to predict users' behavior can typically only be applied to very specific types of user interfaces. An exception is Don Norman's 7 stages of action model, because it can be applied to almost any kind of interface or problem. And what we will look at now is how to use the model in order to avoid the gulf of evaluation and the gulf of execution, understand what Norman actually means with these things. Don Norman is an American scientist, and with this model, the 7 stages of action, he also tries to close another gulf or gap. He tries to close a gap between models that enable to predict users' behavior on one side and mental models on the other, so models that describe what happens in a user's or a developer's mind. And the 7 stages of action, they should help developers to get a better understanding of how users' mental model could work or what could fail if users develop the wrong mental model. So let's look at an example. Imagine I'm in a kitchen and I just open my eyes, and for some reason it's pretty dark in there. So the first thing that might happen is I realize I'm in a dark world, and then that brings us to the first step, or the first gulf, called how it's called by Don Norman, which is the gulf of evaluation. So I realize it's dark, but then I should come to some conclusion about what my goal should be. And in this case, it's a dark world. I like it bright. There should be light. So that could be then my goal. And that's then the first major step, is developing this goal. And then if I have this goal in mind, I of course have to like put that into practice. So there's another gulf, the gulf of execution. I somehow have to figure out how I change my aim or my intention, my goal, into physical actions that bring me to where I want to be, a brighter world. So these steps, and Norman like further drills them down into 7 individual steps, these basically describe the two parts, the two difficult parts. And well, for this example, you might think, like, how hard can it be, right? How hard can it be to get from a dark world to the intention to make it brighter, or from the intention to make it brighter to the actual physical actions? But there are situations where this is actually not as easy as you might guess. So in my mother's kitchen, I haven't figured out how to turn on the light properly. There are switches and they do something, but they don't turn on the light. So I don't understand them. Or in my living room, you can use the switches, but then the light won't go on, but you have to use the voice interface, right, in order to turn on. So this part can be, even for things like making light, pretty hard. The other part is simply not a problem if you want to turn on the light, but we could have a look at the full model and another example. So Norman brings it down to 7 different stages or 7 steps. The first one is you perceive the world, then you interpret your perception, then you compare your perception to like how the world might look like. So you evaluate your interpretation, you use that to form a goal or formalize a goal, then you derive the intent to act. You plan a sequence of action, then you execute the action sequence, and then you hopefully turn on the light. So if you look at an example for this one, let's assume my phone is not recording. So I used to use my phone in order to record lectures. And at one point, my phone didn't properly record videos anymore. So I went back to the camera after like I did my talk, and then realized, oh, phone isn't recording anymore. I then tried to get a try to understand that, and I realized the videos are very short. So it recorded something, but then it was just, I don't know, 20 seconds long. So very short, too short for a lecture. I realized I couldn't record long videos, and I derived the goal that I want to record long videos, right? Then and this part was much harder, right? So then this was my goal, the formalizing the goal, that was okay. But then how do I get there? And that took me half an hour of searching Google. I then realized I have to clean up my phone. I developed an action sequence, deleting trash, deleting caches, deleting old videos. And then, I performed the action on my phone, and then, Word was much better, and then I could record longer videos again. So it was good, and I basically followed these seven stages. We can also get other things out of the model. The first one, that's probably quite easy, it's avoiding the gulf of evaluation, right? And then, of course, avoiding the gulf of execution as well. But avoiding the gulf of evaluation is probably even the more important step. You have to support users in being able to tell the state of the system, and you have to ensure that users can figure out if the system is in the desired state. So you tell them this is a state, and somehow you have to ensure that they can also evaluate the state and that they can map from the system state to an interpretation. So I see the system state, I understand it, and then I also understand the meaning of it. And as we said, the other part is avoiding the gulf of execution. Can users tell what actions are actually possible? Does the device actually support the actions that are necessary in order to change the world? And does the interface help mapping from the intentions to the physical movements? And an example where this is, where we see the difference, right, or where this is much easier from one system compared to another, are graphical user interfaces with menu systems and command line interfaces. For a graphical user interface with a menu, you see all the actions, so it's easy to realize what kind of actions are there. If you have a command line interface, you don't see the actions. And so evaluating or understanding the actions that are there and going from intentions to a sequence plan of actions, it's much, much harder for a command line interface, unless you trained it, right? But if you're untrained or if you have very little training with specific applications, then command line interfaces are much harder to use, and the gulf of execution is one reason for that. So critical points that can be motivated with Norman's seven stages of action are forming inadequate goals. So this is probably the most important step. You have to ensure that users form appropriate goals, because if they form the wrong ones, then, nothing good can come out of it, right? If the goal is wrong, how should they end up in the right place? Not knowing the appropriate actions, of course, not finding the correct actions for it, and receiving inappropriate feedback. So I think this is also critical, that you provide users with appropriate feedback. Because if you went through this circle once, so you went all through all these seven stages, and probably that was difficult as a user. If you don't provide users with feedback, they don't know if they actually ended up in the right spot. So the next time they have to go through these seven stages again, it's as hard as the first time. So you want to provide them with feedback so they know in the end, oh yeah, that was a proper sequence. I did everything correct. And the next time they can benefit from it, because then they can follow the same seven stages. So the principles for good design that can be derived are: system state and actions are always visible, good conceptual models with a consistent system in an image, so the it makes it easier to like map from the system state to the user's mental model. The interface includes good mappings that show the relationship between different stages. So the interface basically helps you to go from one stage to the other, and you provide continuous feedback to users.